Hello guys, how are you? So in this session, I'm going to tell you about how you create and manage the analytics and ML projects. So for that, you have to make a folder, like name it Python course. And whenever I tell you about some topics and whenever I explain you a topic, you have to make a folder, separate folder in that Python course for that. And you make your code, your own code, and keep the dataset in that folder and use that dataset to load in your Python file and execute commands and execute your scripts. So let me show you how you can do this. So here I make a Python course folder, and there I will make some folders like topic one and topic two. Here I tell you about n number of topics. So you, whenever I tell you a new topic, you just go and make a new folder for that topic and assign that name. Like if I name like topic three, or if I tell you about a topic like pandas, so you assign the topic pandas and then enter. And in that topic folder, you have to keep your Python code and your data set. So you can keep in this folder, or else if you keep your projects and keep your Python files in somewhere else and else. So at the end of the course, you will get messed up with your codes and you don't find the exact code what you want. And if you are searching for a specific code in your bundle of codes, then you are get like you were messed up with your codes and you can't find the exact code what you are looking for. So I will recommend you to make a folder Python course, and there you make the folders according to the topics, and there in topic you will save your data set and your Python code or the IPython notebook according to which we are using the IDE. So if we are using the Spider IDE, then we are getting Python file, or we are using PyCharm IDE, then we are getting Python file, PY file, and if we are using Jupyter notebook, then we get IPython notebook, IPYNB file. So that you have to save in the topic folder. And also what you can do is like you keep all the, first you make the Python course folder, and in that course folder you make the n number of topics folder. So here what you can do is make a new folder, set the name like datasets. So here also what you can do is keep all your datasets here. So at the end, what the benefit of this is, like you are executing this topic code and also you are executing this topic code simultaneously, like you are reviewing both the codes at the same time. So when you are executing this topic code, so you have to change the path for this and load this data. And if you are executing this topic code, so you have to again change the path and load this data set. So to solve that problem, you make a new folder datasets, and there you keep all the datasets here. And after this, you don't have to change the path every time. You just have to set the path here and run as many files as you want. Okay. And after that, I also recommend you to make a new folder, like make a new folder and set name like extra coding. In this extra coding folder, what you have to do is make your own Python codes. Like if I am telling you a simple some topic, and if I am telling you one algorithm, then you have to try that algorithm again and again and do some changes in that and try to do research and development on that code and make your code. And you have to practice that code so many times so that it comes in handy and you can understand what is going on in that code. So to understand that code, you have to practice many times, because if you are just seeing the course and just by seeing me doing coding, you don't learn the code. So you have to practice that code on your own. So the codes which I tell you, you save here in the topic wise folder, and the codes which you are doing, you can save, make an extra folder and save all the notebooks here, all the Python files here, or you can make this folder in the topic wise. Like here you make extra folder, extra coding folder, where you save your topic wise extra codings so that you can enhance your skills, else you won't learn this Python coding and else you won't learn how to code if you are just seeing me doing coding stuff. So if you are worried about like where you get from this data set and where do you get these data sets, so no, don't worry about that. I will provide all the links and the data set from where you get these data sets on your system, and you can load that data set from that. So that's all for today's session, that how you can manage your data set and manage your Python course project, Python course and their files. So thank you. Bye-bye. Take care. Thank you.